Hey there guys, I'm Jesse Crowe, the travelling scientist, and today I'm looking at the question of whether or not you should get the flu vaccine this year. So I used to work in vaccine development, and something that always surprised me is that the influenza vaccine isn't 100% effective. Depending on the strain of the virus and how the vaccine was developed, usually there's only between a 40 and 80% chance that the vaccine will actually protect you. You see, the influenza virus is always circulating the globe, mutating and changing its structure so it can get past our immune systems and infect us. So when the World Health Organization is developing a vaccine to protect us against this virus, it has to predict how the virus is going to mutate several months in advance so that companies have enough time to develop the vaccine and produce enough of it to spread to the large population. However, sometimes their predictions are wrong, and sometimes the virus might mutate differently and the vaccine might be a bit of a mismatch to the virus, making it less effective. So there's a slight chance that even if you do get the influenza vaccine, you might still get the flu. I know, it sucks, right? Then there's also the side effects you can get from the vaccine, like aches or a bit of a fever. That's just a normal immune response from getting a foreign substance injected into your arm. So let me explain how it works. The influenza vaccine can either be inactivated or recombinant. Inactivated means that the virus in the vaccine is dead, so it can't cause infection. And recombinant means that the vaccine looks similar to the influenza virus, so it'll produce an immune response. But in both cases, the vaccine against the flu cannot make you sick. It can't. You're not getting injected with the flu. There is no possible way that getting a vaccine against the flu can give you the flu. It doesn't make sense. It's impossible. Just want to make that clear. What happens is the vaccine is actually recognized by your immune system, and it's kind of like putting wanted posters up all over your body so it knows what the flu looks like. So if you do encounter the influenza virus later on, all the cells in your body are like, hey, that's the guy, let's get him. And they all like jump on this flu virus and like tackle it down and kill it before it can actually, you know, give you the flu. And this is why you should get the influenza vaccine. It's unlikely, but it is possible that the influenza virus could mutate into a pandemic strain. This happened in 1919, that's 99 years ago. It was called the Spanish flu, which I think is a little bit racist, but that's just me. It killed over 50 million people around the world. 50 million. It wasn't just killing elderly people and young children. It was mainly killing healthy adults. People between the age of 20 and 40 were getting infected and being killed by this influenza strain. And there's no reason why that couldn't happen again this year. Also, if you get vaccinated, you're one less person that could potentially carry the disease and spread it to others. It's not just about protecting yourself, but about protecting the people around you as well. Also, in Australia, if you're pregnant, if you're over 65, or if you have a long-term medical condition, the vaccine's free, so why not get it? Look, ultimately, the decision is yours, and that's obvious. I'm not gonna tell you what to do, but I can give you your options. You can either face the pain, protect yourself and those around you. It's cheap as chips, but it might not work. Or you can take the risk, not get the vaccine. Maybe you don't even need it and you won't encounter the virus. But without the vaccination, you're more likely to get influenza. And that could kill you. But it probably won't. I don't know. Last thing to note is the vaccine takes 1 to 2 weeks to build up that immunity. Usually get it mid to late autumn, just before winter, when influenza's at its peak. And if you've got any serious concerns about the vaccine, just ask your local doctor. Anyway, that's all for today, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you like this video, please click the like button down below and let me know what you think about the flu vaccine and vaccines in general in the comments section down below. Finally, subscribe for more traveling science every week and I'll see you guys next time. Cheers. Let me tell you a quick story. It was called the Spanish flu, and that could kill you. So when the World Health Organization is jump on this, tackle it down and kill it before it can actually mutate differently, which I think is a little bit racist. I know, it sucks, right?